College Online Assembly. I'd like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land, the Kurrerong people, and pay my respects to their elders past, present, and emerging.
Good morning, Mortlake College community. Welcome to our online assembly this week. Been a bit going on, so it's not quite your usual razzle-dazzle assembly this week. We'll return bigger and better the following week. We've got some comedy gold up our sleeves, but not so much. It's all about business this week. As you will have heard, we are returning to school on Tuesday, the 26th of May for prep year one and year two students and year 11 and year 12 students and any students in year 10 that do a VCE subject only will be able to attend when that subject is on at school. So we're pretty much going into our normal timetable for Prep 1, 2 students and year 11 and 12 with some year 10 students involved. Then 2 weeks later on the 9th of June is a start for all students from year prep to year 12. So years 3 to year 10 are back full time for the last 3 weeks of term. So it's a staggered start. That's what the government's asked for. So we're doing a staggered start starting on Tuesday, May the 26th. So exciting stuff. Just be aware, make sure you keep looking at the Facebook, the college website, school bag app for all the latest information. There'll be lots of information being put out every few days with reminders and updates of things that are happening to make our transition back. So it is a staggered start, and the one thing is that it is about keeping everyone safe and practicing the social distancing. So there'll be some changes in classrooms, changes to, there'll be a big emphasis on washing our hands and the use of the good old hand sanitizer. So we have more sanitizer at school than you can poke a stick at or sink a ship with, and more on the way. So we've got lots of hand sanitizer, so there'll be hand sanitizer in every room. Students that catch the school bus, the school buses will be up and running again. I will suggest that please be a few minutes earlier to your bus stop than usually planned, because there's less students on the bus, so the buses might be a minute or two earlier, but we'll try and get them to stick to the regular times as much as possible. So the transport will be on. If you're needing childcare, you need to get that form in. It will be tricky with what we offer from the start of school returning. There'll be less staff on the ground to offer the childcare, but we will work through that. But the big thing is, we'll let you know that we will be safe for hand washing. We'll have the new toilet block open for senior students. Hopefully we'll have access to the new classrooms as well, but we will have a big emphasis on washing our hands, hand sanitising, and keeping social distance. And that will be in place in the schoolyard and in the classroom as well. So that will be one. A couple of the simple things that will be happening. To let you know, a lot of the some of the curriculum areas, such as food, some heavily group-based activities, will change, especially this term too. We might be doing rotation through cooking classes, and different things might be broken into halves. So we can maintain the safe distancing for everyone. So, but the teachers will let you know about what changes there are. Unfortunately, we won't be able to have big school gatherings at the moment. So assemblies, camps, excursions, they've all been temporarily banned by the government at the moment too. So once you pretty much stay local, which is fine, and we'll go by that. So we will keep you posted if there's upcoming sports events in terms 3 and 4, and whether or not we get some excursion and camps in this year. It is sort of all up in the air. We're all learning as we go. So it's really important though that we still follow the rules. I know we're out, able to get out and about. Probably the big thing from our point of view is that if you have a son or daughter that ends up going down with the flu and showing flu-like symptoms, they will need to remain home and isolate in the home. So I think that's probably one of the big changes moving forward, is that we probably won't put up with the runny nose and the coughing fits and all that, because we really want to keep everyone safe, because we don't want the school population going down sick. And it is tricky because we're going into winter, you've been isolating, but please think of everyone else as health as we move forward. So that's it from the Mortlake College newsroom this week, and we will catch you again next week. Hello, Mortlake Year 10, 11, and 12 students. So you're back at school in just under 2 weeks. As you know from the start of the year, you've been not allowed to bring your mobile phones to school. Tuesday the 26th of May, you're all going to be issued with a phone locker key, all right, in your house colour. Before home group each day, phone goes there, key goes to a safe spot in your new locker, away we go. At the end of the day, at 3:20, you can come up, collect your mobile phone, and you're away. Because as the new government rules say, between 9 and 3:30, mobile phones are banned in Victorian government schools. I'll now throw to a commercial break. Products that should be made into commercials. Take one. Black and gold minced garlic. Makes you big and strong. Oh, the pop of goodness. I just use it like a dip. It tastes so good. I can eat it by the spoonful. Look at that garlicky goodness. So when you need to spice up your cooking, use black and gold garlic. Best bargain in the shopping aisle, bar none. Black and gold minced garlic, the ideal pandemic food. No one will come within 1.5 metres of you if you eat it raw. Adverts that should be made for products that don't exist.
Matter of fact, I got it now.
Why is my Chromebook not turning on? First, check your connections to make sure it's plugged in at both ends. If it's still not working, hold down the refresh button and the power button together for several seconds. This will reset the internal power system. Now it should be working just fine.
Show me a piece of your heart, a piece of your love. I'm calling you up to getting down, down, down. The way that we touch is never enough. I'm turning you up to getting down, down. Show me a piece of your heart, a piece of your love. I'm calling you up to getting down, down, down. The way that we touch is never enough. Turning you up to getting down, down, down.
What, sorry, just quickly, what if it's
da 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 down, down, down. Da 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 da.
get down. So get out your seat and jump around. Jump around. Jump around. Jump around. Jump up, jump up and get down. Jump, jump, jump. Everybody jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Everybody jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jump. I'll serve your ass like John McEnroe. If your girl steps up, I'm smacking the hoe. Word to your moms, I came to drop bombs. I got more rhymes and the Bible's got psalms. And just like the prodigal son, I've returned.
Song to you for 20 seconds, rinsing with nice warm water and using paper towel to dry our hands. Hi there, I thought we'd make some really delicious golden syrup dumplings. Everyone seems to think that they're their favorites. Today I'm making a Maggie beer version, so I'm actually got the recipe printed off. And I will tick off as we're going. So it shows you that remembering when you need to add your ingredients and whatever. So today we need 1 cup of self-raising flour, and it says unsalted butter, but I only had salted butter, so I won't add the extra salt. And 1 egg whisked and 50 mils of milk. So that's gonna make the dumpling section. So it's 1 cup of flour. You sieve that so it puts a bit of air into it. And then we're going to use the rub in method. So it's just putting your butter in. So remembering that was 20 grams of butter. So it's just a nice little slice of butter. Ideally, the butter should be nice and cold. It makes it a lot easier, but today my kitchen's quite warm, and the rubbing in method is obviously using your fingertips and rubbing the butter and the flour to actually resemble breadcrumbs. Sometimes it does take a little bit of time, and it is easier, I think, when the butter is really nice and hard, because it gets a bit mushy in your hand, so you gotta try and be quick as you can be. A little tip that when you think you're right, you get your bowl and you give it a bit of a shimmy, and when that happens, the big lumpy bits of butter come to the top, so you go, okay, I need to keep going with my breadcrumbs. So it's really important to get those nice breadcrumbs, because we want to have these dumplings really light and fluffy, and this is the only time it's going to happen, because as soon as we add the liquids, that's when we've got to be really gentle. So a couple more passes through with your fingers. And don't use the palm of your hand. See how my palms of my hands are clean? It's just on my fingertips. You just want to use your fingertips. So you don't want the extra heat of your hands going into the flour and the butter. And I'm adding a little bit of extra air as well by lifting it up. But I just wanted to show you what it looks like. Now, this recipe adds an egg. So I'm now going to show you that when we go into the method, we've got sift the flour in a bowl, rub in the butter and the flour until it resembles breadcrumbs. So I'm actually going to tick that, and it says now to add the whisked egg. So I'm going to make a quick well in my flour. I've got my 1 egg and I'm going to quickly whisk it up. Whisking, all it means is to get the yellow and the white, also it's one instead of separate. Now that's going to be added. And it says in the instructions under the method, to just stir till combined, so don't overdo it. So I've just given that a bit of a stir, and then gently add your milk to the mix and it'll come together. It's a little bit like making scones. So I'm going to drop my fork down now, and I like using a knife because it's a cutting in method now. And we're just going to cut the flour with the liquid. And you can see it's all coming together now, so it's all starting to stick together. It's pretty important not to overdo it. So once it comes all together, we're going to put that aside and let that rest for a moment whilst we actually get our sauce all organized. So that's all together, nice little dough. Time to make the sauce. So looking at our sauce ingredients, we needed 1/2 cup of golden syrup and 1 2/3 cups of water, which I've got in together with the jug. It's 3/4 cup of brown sugar. I'm ticking these off as I'm going. Brown sugar is the only ingredient you can actually use a bit of force and push it down. Firmly packed, it's called. We need 30 grams of butter. So we're gonna pop that into our large fry pan. I normally do this in a saucepan, but Maggie Beer says to do it in a frying pan. So all into the frying pan we go. The brown sugar, in we go. And the 30 grams of butter, in we go. The only thing I'm going to add to this is a couple of strips of lemon zest, just the outside bit. We'll keep them as nice big strips which we can pull out of the sauce. I just like lemons. Now it does say to put it on a high heat to bring it to the boil, so having an adult to help you with the stove. And we've got our gas going, and we'll need to bring that to the boil. So when it comes to the boil and it starts to bubble, we'll turn it down and we'll simmer it. Now, as we're bringing our sauce to the boil, we need to give it a bit of a stir so we make sure that that brown sugar is not sticking to the bottom. Being very careful, because it's sugary syrup is quite dangerous when it starts to heat up. You can see that the butter is starting to dissolve and melt down. It'll get nice and glossy soon, but I can see now that the sugar's all dissolved. So we'll go and actually start making our little dumplings now. One of Maggie's really good tips in her method is to use some flour on your hands, which we can call our baker's gloves sometimes. So you just get a bit of flour and you rub your hands, and now you've got a bit of flour on them. Just helps to make the dough not to stick to you. Now, this is asking for 20 cent piece little sizes. So we're going to quickly do a bit of a roll up. And if your hands get a little sticky, a little bit more flour. Being really gentle with this dough, because we don't want to make it hard. So gentle rolling. And another little tip is on the back side here of my instructions is to use a baking tray with a bit of baking paper, because she's wanting us to actually pop these balls all together into the frying pan when it comes down to the simmer. So we'll just keep our hands well floured. So we don't want to add any more flour to our mixture, so being careful not to put too much flour in there. Oh, I love golden syrup dumplings. Already the smell of the golden syrup and the brown sugar on the stove, it's so delicious. So totally delicious. So whenever I've made golden syrup dumplings, I don't normally use an egg. So this is quite a different recipe that I'm using, but I like the challenge of doing something different. The last time I cooked golden syrup dumpling was actually outside. And we had a campfire and a really gorgeous old cast iron pot, and we waited for the fire to go down with some coals, and then just the excitement of waiting for the golden syrup dumplings to be cooked was amazing. So our golden syrup dumpling sauce has just come to the boil. I'm turning the stove down, and now it's time to very carefully put our dumplings in, making sure that you use the method of away splash, because you don't want to do it towards you in case it does splash, because it can be quite dangerous. If this is too hard for you, get an adult to help you, please, because this is a time for you to be sensible. Now, in Maggie B's recipe, she says to cover this with foil. So I'm going to follow the instructions. So covering with a piece of foil. It says to firmly cover, so it means I've just made it look the shape, same shape as the frying pan. And then lid on. Cook for 10 minutes and then we'll turn them over, and then they should be ready to serve with some beautiful cream or ice cream. Another really good tip is when you're finished with your dough out of your bowl, take it straight to the sink and top it up with some water, because if there's any little bits of flour left in, this will actually help when it comes to the cleanup. Any little tips for when it's cleanup time is a good tip. It's been 10 minutes, it's time now to turn them over. The steam from our frying pan, open the lid away so the steam goes away from you, and you're making sure that you be careful of the drips on the bottom of the frying pan lid. Using your tongs, also with your foil, making sure that the steam's going away from you, put it upside down, then get our spoon and our fork and very carefully, very gently, turn the dumplings over. They're nice and light and fluffy so far. Yum. And then we're going to cover them over again. Sealing it in, all the steam in, so it's quite firm, but not pushing down on top of the dumplings. Being gentle but firm at the same time. Lid back on, looking at our clock or our watch or setting our timer. We might set it for 8 minutes and check it. It does say 10, a further 10 minutes, but we can check and then redo it if we have to. So another 10 minutes and then we'll be ready. So the timer's gone off on the 8 minutes, so we'll check our golden syrup dumplings. Taking the lid off with the steam going away, ensuring that the drips don't go on us, so careful. Using our tongs to pick up the foil. Also, look at all that steam. Being careful that we haven't got our face near the steam. Oh yeah, baby, look at those bubbling beautiful golden syrup dumplings. We're going to turn the stove off and then we'll serve up. Now, any sugar that's bubbling like that is bound to be really hot, so be very careful. Have the frying pan and everything nice and safe, close to the bowl. We could let this sit for a while and wait, but we're gonna do it straight away. So I'm using a spoon, carefully popping it into our bowl. How many do we think we should have in the bowl? I think we'll go with two, but there's plenty there. So we'll go with two beautiful golden syrup dumplings. And I've got a little bit of ice cream here. You could have some cream, you can have none if you want, just have it all nude. But let's go with some luscious ice cream, just vanilla, and then some extra gorgeous syrup on the top. Now remember, I just put the lemon zest in there, so we don't want to have any of that lemon zest on there. So beautiful bit of the golden syrup sauce drizzled on the top, and we'll open it all up and see what it looks like inside. Oh, it's so soft and fluffy. It's just beautiful. Having to blow it because it's so hot, but my mouth is watering. Yep. Thank you very much, Maggie Beer, for this gorgeous recipe. I think I'm going to use this one forever. Cheers for now. Bye.
Matter of fact, I got it now. Ready?
Yep.
Matter of fact, I got it now. Oh.